Khrushchev brimmed with confidence. He hated formality. He acted on impulse. He loved a fight. He wanted to make the Soviet Union happy as well as glorious.
He believed that socialism had to be liberated from the debris of Stalin's rule and from bureaucracy. It should be made more democratic. The gates should be opened, but gradually, step by step. Because for him, socialism was like paradise on earth.
To show his confidence, Khrushchev allowed an American exhibition into Moscow in 1959. For the first time, Russians could touch and taste the American achievement.
Coca-Cola or Pepsi-Cola? Pepsi-Cola. And Coca-Cola? No, Coca-Cola.
Some of the women complain sometimes that it smells like benzene. And men wanted to know if it would make them drunk.
But Khrushchev knew that the Soviet Union was beating America in the space race. For Khrushchev, here was evidence that communism meant not just power, but technical progress. The first generation of Soviet cosmonauts, Gagarin, Titov, and the first woman in space, Valentina Tereshkova, became instant national heroes. They personified Khrushchev's vision, a modernized, vigorous Soviet Union which would lead the world into the future. The Soviet Union's natural resources seemed limitless. Khrushchev believed that the Soviet people would work even harder if they were freed from fear and poverty.
Коммунисты живут не хуже, а лучше многих стран. А в будущем мы будем жить так, как ни одна страна не живет. Это я вам говорю.
But the Cold War's pressure to rearm kept the old priority for heavy industry alive, especially in the expanding defense sector.
Дорога была вся расчерчена.
They would shout, come on, come on, speed up. But sometimes we used to get irritated, because we knew, even without their orders, that we had to hurry up. We knew that there was a threat that bombs and missiles could reach us, so we had to defend ourselves. There was no feeling that we were on equal terms with the West, or that we could come to any agreement.
The Cold War also kept huge armed forces in the field. Khrushchev tried to cut them back, but the generals resisted.
It was very prestigious to join the military. First, because you earned a higher wage. When I graduated, I was paid 240 rubles, and an engineer only got 120 rubles. Also, I received 5 uniforms, and that mattered. And in the military, you got an apartment.
Cities like Sverdlovsk, 900 miles east of Moscow, were dominated by giant armaments plants. Production was a matter of fulfilling or outstripping targets set by the planners in Moscow. Patriotic propaganda kept the workers straining to produce more and faster.
We believed that it was our duty to the motherland, and we worked very hard. A lot of young people worked at our factory. About 3,000 young communists, Komsomol members,
свой комитет комсомола. Мы создавали комсомольско-молодежные бригады. Были соревнования.
We had our own committee, and we created youth brigades, which competed against each other.
Ну, скромными кубок заводской.
The best brigades were awarded pennants and trophies.
Лучшей бригаде давали.
Хрущев and the party still relied on propaganda and patriotism to keep the economy going.
В ответ на провокации американской военщины мы, металлурги, будем трудиться еще лучше. И пусть каждая сверхплановая тонна нашего уральского металла укрепляет могущество нашей Родины.
People forgave us a lot because of the Cold War. The West didn't only harm us, it also helped us. Because by frightening us, it played into our hands. We could say to the people, tighten up your belts, be patient. We have to wait for a better life and be prepared for the worst. And we use that.
Вроде бы такая огромная страна.
We had such a huge country with vast resources. All the people worked. So why were we dressed so badly in whatever we should lay our hands on and ate whatever there was and not what we wanted?
Едим, что попало. Совсем не то, что хотелось бы, понимаете?
The explanation was simple.
Все объяснялось очень просто.
Uncle Sam and the imperialists are making an atomic bomb.
Называли империалисты.
So we had to make two in order to frighten them.
Бомбу.
If they made two bombs, we had to produce four.